You know, there's nothing quite like sitting down after a long day and reading through the new natural history articles that have come out. Let's see here. Growth of the ear in alligator. Oldest record of decapitation in the New World. Violent. Oh, giant carnivorous mammal from France. I'm not really a mammal fan. I'll just leave this behind. Who wrote this? Florial Zelay, Eli Amson. Matthew Borths? That Matthew Borths? My co-host? The one who's currently sitting alone in rural Ohio writing his dissertation furiously? He can't do this episode. I have to cover this mammal. This one's for you, Matt. I'm Adam Pritchard, and this is a Pastime News Bite. From the journal PLOS ONE, a new large hyena lurine from the Bartonian of Europe and its bearings on the evolution and ecology of massive hyena dons. Now, this new article by Dr. Florian Zelay of the Royal Belgian Institute of Natural Sciences and his colleagues describes an amazing specimen of a fossil mammal group called the creodonts. To introduce creodonts, we begin at the end of the age of dinosaurs 66 million years ago. The great reptiles have died out, and the mammals begin to come out of the trees and out of the shadows and conquer land ecosystems. After the dinosaurs died, the ancestors of cats, dogs, bears, they didn't become the chief carnivores on this earth. For many millions of years, their ancestors remained small, weasel-like predators, never much larger than a house cat. For more than 20 million years, most of the mammal carnivores on this earth were creodonts. If you look in any old encyclopedia of prehistoric life, you'll usually find one creodont species. An animal from about 25 million years ago in North America, Europe, and Asia called hyenodon, which looks like a wolf with a cartoonishly huge head. And for a long time, that's what I thought all of the creodonts looked like. But this is ludicrous because it ignores tons of fossil evidence in museums around the world. There are creodonts that look like giant bears. Some of them look like tiny weasels. Some of them look nothing like carnivorous mammals we have today. Some lived in trees. Some may have spent most of the time in the water. Matt never stops talking about them, which makes sense because it's his dissertation. But as a result, I've learned that this group is amazing and dynamic. Matt and a number of other scientists, including Dr. Zelay and his team, have been trying to figure out how all these creodonts interrelate and how they changed with the changing world of the Cenozoic. It's great because now we have North American and European scientists collaborating towards that common goal, and today's new discovery is a part of that puzzle. Now, one thing we definitely see at the very beginning of the age of mammals is that they quickly increase in body size. Herbivores within a few million years become sheep and cow size. A few million years after that, they're the size of rhinos and elephants. And at the same time the herbivores are increasing in size, we see the carnivores increase in size as well. And with that, I bring you to what will become the continent of Europe during the Eocene epoch, some 40 million years ago. Rather than a single continuous continent, Europe is broken up into many different islands, all covered in hot tropical forests, and home to a huge diversity of different kinds of mammals. And there's a great deal of evolution and extinction going on at this time, not just from smaller to bigger. And a lot of this appears to be related to climatic changes that are happening throughout the Eocene. Now, ever since the extinction of the dinosaurs some 24 million years prior, the most diverse and successful group of carnivorous mammals in Europe is a group of creodonts called hyenodonts. During most of the Eocene of Europe, you're not likely to see a carnivorous mammal that's more than, say, 50 pounds. No larger than a modern coyote. Until 40 million years ago, when a monster appeared on the continent. And that's the animal that's the subject of today's episode. Kerberos. Named for a multi-headed dog guardian of the underworld in Greek mythology, Kerberos is well over twice the size of the largest creodonts that preceded it in the fossil record. At the time it lived in Europe, it was the largest carnivorous mammal that had ever lived on that continent. Almost 200 pounds. Twice the size of a modern timber wolf. The animal is known from a massive skull, which has an appearance kind of caught between a dog and a bear. A relatively short face, but with a lot of long, sharp teeth. Ideal for slicing through meat. Now, Kerberos and its relatives have three pairs of meat-slicing teeth called carnassials, whereas modern dogs have only one pair. You could say that a Kerberos skull has the same number of meat slicers as three dog skulls. See what they did there? Three-headed dog? clever. Now, in addition to the skull, they have some bones from the hind limb of this animal. And in this case, they are very massive bones. They're not suggestive of a very fast-running creature. Kerberos may have walked something like a modern bear, with its whole foot on the ground, rather than walking on its toes like modern cats and dogs. The authors also analyzed the relationships of Kerberos to other creodonts, and they discovered that it's actually closely related to some African animals, suggesting that there was interchange happening between the animals of Africa and the animals of Europe at that time. And that's a pattern we see broadly in other mammal groups as well. On past time, when we do episodes like this, we often refer only to the first author on a paper, and then refer to and his colleagues or and her colleagues. But those colleagues, though they're not leading the project, often have roles absolutely critical to the completion of a project. In this case, there are six authors on this paper, in addition to the lead, Dr. Zolay. Now, Matt specifically brought an understanding of African members of the hyaenodonts, and also a strong grounding in the limb skeleton of other mammals, which allowed him to make comparisons that the other authors couldn't have made. He also contributed to a discussion of how they should build a tree of relationships, which animals they should include, and which anatomical traits should go into that interpretation. And that is the power of collaboration in science. And that's how Kerberos has contributed to a new understanding of past times.